If you know where you come from, you are, you're a helper. Well, well, baby, let me ask you something. How old
right.
are
you?
Yeah. So I was like, okay then, well, like you can be blah, blah, encourage her.
That's right. Amen. Amen. That's right.
Amen. Yes. Amen.
As we get ready to come, look at the scripture. If we want to see a change in our community, if we want to see a change happen in our churches, y'all, we got to do this right here. If my people, look right there. If my people, God is saying right here to his people, regardless of what color we is, we all are God's people. And we all are. See, I don't know about y'all, but I don't see color. Because of the love of God, Jesus' blood. So I don't see color. All I see is my brother and my sister. But at the same time, I'm really concerned with my race of people. Because the more and more I look at the news, the more and more I look at the bad and busted. The more and more I read the police blog. I got some law enforcement friends. They talk to me. What you do this weekend, bro? Man, they had locked folks up, man. Oh, friend? What you locked up? Who locked up? Who you locked up? Man, this man. Old guy on there, so-and-so, man, shoot, man. Him and his brother got the all fighting, cussing going on. And man, you know, then the other called his family, they came over there and they jumped on him and this, that. Had to ask the last question. What color they were? Well, they black folks. We doing worse to one another than folk doing to us, y'all. So until we put value back in us,
that's right. Amen.
We can't expect the world to respect us. We can't expect the world to handle us no different than we handle ourselves.
Amen.
So what we got to do, we got to start loving our own skin color. Amen. We got to start talking to our own kind. Like, encourage one another.
Yes.
Talk to one another.
Yes.
Like, and with respect, knowing where we come from.
Yes.
If you got a disagreement, talk about it. But don't let it stay there. Why? Because we're trying to stay together as a race. Look at what the scripture said. If my people who are called by my name will what? Humble. First thing God do, get humble. Come on, come down off your high horse. I don't care how high I get. I know where I come from now. I know I'm a Thompson. I know I come from the Howard family. I know my lineage. I know who I am.
Yes.
No matter how high I get, I know where I come from.
Yes.
I know my folks are from Lexington, Georgia.
Mm-hmm.
I know my dad is from Carlton, Georgia.
Mm-hmm.
That is, I'm not going to forget that. I know what my ancestors went through. So therefore, the higher I get, the more I still try to stay connected. Why? Because y'all, we got to grow together as a race. Look, humble themselves and pray and seek my face. But next thing we got to do, turn. There it is. Turn from that wicked way. What that wicked way is here. See, let me tell y'all something. It is by design we see when little apartment buildings come up over here. Like just say for example. Like it has. You got Nelly B. Rock Spray. That was by design. And by design, guess what you're gonna have also? You got Family Dollars over here. But then you got a liquor store.
Oh, no.
That's by design.
That's right.
Mm-hmm. Watch this. Because they know that there's a lot of crime that's going to happen in this area. So they put these types of people, most of them, and they did it in the 70s. They didn't understand that where the ghetto came from. They put they put black folk in a certain area because they knew that they're unlearned, they're untrained, and then what we're gonna do? We're gonna put some packet stones and little stones and pounding nails around because why? They were breaking them. But then they gonna get over here because they gonna get drunk with this because they got to have it. And if they keep drunk with this, guess what? Then they always gonna look out for a handout. Government assistance. And see, right now, what we doing as a black race of folks, instead of us getting the government assist and say, you know what, I'm going to stay on this about a year, but then I'm going to find me a job, yes, and then I'm going to work, and then what I'm going to do, I'm going to cut that out. Yes. What we do? What we do? Somebody done told you to go to me, kid. You know the government will pay for it, especially if you don't tell them my daddy.
Yes.
So now you got four children. Check that thing, come from the government. You driving a charge. 2017 charge. But it's in front of apartment. No land. Get food stamp. And now, not only, ladder, you don't even use it. You put it on Facebook, I got the food stamp, whoever needs all holler. You picking the system and wonder why your children in the mentality that they can't do nothing in school. Why? Because you buy them all tennis shoes, you can put them in all these clothes, and you use the government money to do it, and you lazy and won't find a job, and every dude you deal with is somebody that's hanging around the house.
Amen.
Now you got a job. And you tell the government you can't find what a dad is, but he's standing in the house with you, not paying child support. But you're trying to get that. See how we do it. And that's why he had that. Because we ain't got nothing. We ain't got sisters up there. Go ahead and look. Everybody need a little sister. I ain't got food stamps for. But I got, and I need, I want some now if they do. But I'm not going to pimp the system because I don't want my children to see me.
That's
right. Pimp the system.
That's right.
Because if you stay in that system, what's going to happen is you will never advance. That's right. This is what God talking about. Turn from them. You got folk having 4th of July party out of food stamps.
Amen.
Come on over, cuz. We got the alcohol, got the beer and everything, man. Come on over here. Turn.
Yes.
From that wicked way. Then I will. Then what Luke God said, then I will hear from them. And will forgive their and heal their land. As I close.
Jesus.
We've come a long way. We got yet long to go.
Amen.
Teach your children, y'all. I'm going to tell you another thing. Have a good. See, we got to break generational curses.
Yes. Right. Yes.
I'll be the first to tell you, I had a child out of wedlock. I had a child young. I was 18 years old when I had my daughter. Be the first to tell you. But when my daughter got old enough, I told her, don't do this. You're not a mistake, but don't fall in it. So I'm going to tell you what happens when you have children young. Mm-hmm. See, notice when I was young, I had mom and I had big mom.
Oh. Yeah.
Big mom will teach wisdom. Mama will go make sure she bagged up the wheels of that big mom talk.
Yeah, yeah.
So you had some tradition that was passed down,
yes,
that made me the man that I am today, although I made mistakes, but I still had my razor to lean back on.
Right.
How to look a man in the eye and shake his hand. How you doing, sir? Mm-hmm. How to give a firm grip.
Yes.
How you doing, sir? Mm-hmm. How to open up doors for the ladies.
Amen.
You see a little elderly lady going in the store, how to wait on her.
Amen.
That's what they taught us, respect. Yeah. sugar than him. You have a child at 15. You turn 30, that child 15. That child have a child at 15. Now, all of y'all, mama, grandmama, and the daughter in the same generation. When grandmother wanna when mama wanna go to the club, can you keep silent? No, but I'm going out too, honey. So you leave the child somewhere with somebody else that don't know what's going on. Yes. Then that's how that child ends up praying. Why? Cause ain't nobody watching. Then you got four folks of the same generation. Who teaching who? It's no tradition of being passed down because there is none. Amen. Everybody in the granddaughter, mama, grandmama, and great grandmama, all in the same category. All of them on Facebook. All of them know computer technology. All of them know, and nobody know about cooking. Everybody know about Jim Newton. Put your hot pocket in, by the way, honey, I'm gonna get ready to go. I gotta go over here. Four women in the same generation. And the reason why they don't know, they ain't been taught. Because mama don't know because she young. Grandma don't know because she young. Great grandma don't know because she young. So the information has been passed down because everybody's young. That's why back in the day, when y'all were coming up, folks were old when they were having children. 40 years old. 45 years old, you still, so they still have children. But guess what? They had something passed down to the children.
Yes.
What we got to do is, elderly, we got to get our little grandchildren. I mean, little grandchildren, grandchildren, grandma. I mean, granddaughter, grandson. Sit down and talk to them. Men. You, whatever your trade is, pass it down to them. Like D.C., know how to do cars, do all that stuff. Get little Zion. So this I look, then I change the tie. You sure? This I put these park rules in. This I do these right here. Why? Pass down the information. So they'll learn when they get old, they'll know how to be men of their house.
Yes.
My granddaddy taught me. My grandmama taught me that. The problem is, y'all, the information is not being passed down.
That's right.
So therefore, you got a whole bunch of savages.
That's right.
You got a whole bunch of black little boys that don't know nothing about respect because it ain't been passed down. And they dad ain't teaching them why they were locked up in jail, doing fooling in, got banned all over the town. Look, the little dad got four or five brothers that he don't even know. Because the dad that run around, ain't nobody talking how to look, man. If you keep doing this, man, you go, child's gonna kill you. That what they make me? Calm down. Child's gonna. $400 or $500 coming out of my check every week, and I wouldn't make much. I ain't gonna eat 10. Sometimes I'm getting a check, $23 every day. No, man. They ain't got me somewhere in that damn. Or either. I learned how to be wilder when I go with my dealers.
That's right.
Learn how to stop by the store out there with before I go on. If I know what I'm talking about. Anyway, man, I'm talking about. But my point is, let's educate. Pass the information down. And us as elders, let us continue to remind one another. Y'all know where we came from. We can't act like that. We can't treat one another like this. We can't look at each other sideways. All of y'all, all our parents came from somewhere.
Amen.
And we got to respect one another and keep one another going forward. Amen?
Amen.
Doors of the church is now open. Oh.